Hello. We can often say that a dog is grateful, but how do we understand that this is gratitude exactly? People can express gratitude in dozens of ways. We can hug each other, say thank you, send flowers. We have many options, really. But how about dogs? How do they express gratitude? Do they do it by giving a look or a kiss or by wagging their tail? Are dogs even capable of feeling gratitude? Well, let's see. You did something that your dog really enjoys. For example, you took them for a walk in the forest or gave them their favorite treat. Of course, your dog is happy. They enjoy walks, treats, and other wonderful things you offer them. Does it mean your dog thinks, "Thank you so much, my human"? There's a possibility that yes, they do. The key to understanding gratitude is empathy. We can't feel gratitude if we're not able to put ourselves in the shoes of a person who's done us a favor or done something nice. After all, they have sacrificed something for us. If there was no empathy or understanding of somebody's sacrifice, we would simply feel joy when getting a gift or a service, which is also nice, of course, but not gratitude. Scientists at the University of Vienna conducted a study, the results of which have clearly shown that dogs understand and react to human emotion. That is, they can feel empathy. Dogs were placed in one room with their owners who were reading books and listening to music through headphones, completely ignoring their pets. There were also speakers in this room that transferred different sounds. There were three types of sounds. Sounds of a dog's speech, joyful or sad, for example, a dog's playful barking or whining. Sounds made by people, for example, laughter and crying, as well as neutral sounds, for example, a waterfall or a people's speech that does not express specific emotions. It turned out that dogs show more emotional reaction to emotionally colored sounds. It didn't matter whether these sounds were made by dogs or by people. Moreover, dogs often froze when they heard sounds with negative emotional coloring, for example, a dog's whining or a person's crying. That means that dogs perfectly understand the difference between joy and distress of another being. In turn, this means that dogs are capable of empathy, which, as already mentioned, is the basis of gratitude. How do dogs express gratitude? Of course, dogs can't say thank you in words, but at the same time, they can express gratitude with the help of body language. For example, dogs express gratitude by relaxedly wagging their tail, looking at us with shining eyes, and smiling. But are dogs the only animals that are capable of gratitude? There is a possibility that some animals are capable of behavior that can be interpreted as gratitude. For example, there was a case when two chimpanzees, who were released from a cage during a storm so that they could escape, did not run away immediately, but stopped to hug the person who opened the cage. However, the gratitude expressed by dogs is related to some certain specific things. There's no evidence that dogs can be grateful for something global, like, for example, rescuing them from a shelter or from the street. Dogs live in the moment, right here and right now, and if they're scared of the changing environment, they're unlikely to be grateful. However, if you can provide such a dog with a comfortable life, build trusting relationships, and bring them joy every day, they will be grateful. Of course, the behavior of other animals has yet to be examined, and we'll probably learn a lot of new and interesting things about what other living beings feel and how they express their emotions.